हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ मनोज पोपटानी। आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द एडुपीडिया वर्ल्ड। आई होप यू गाइज आर हैविंग अ ग्रेट टाइम टुडे एंड आई बिलीव यू गाइज आर कॉन्स्टेंटली रिवाइजिंग द टॉपिक्स विच आर बींग टॉट इन द अर्लियर प्रेजेंटेशन एज वेल। विद दैट बिलीव एंड फेथ इन ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज, लेट्स जस्ट रिमाइंड यू ऑफ द टॉपिक्स विच वी हैव कवर्ड इन दिस चैप्टर सो फार। वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड वॉट आर बॉन्ड्स, key terms relating to bonds, difference between bond and a debenture. We've already covered valuation of bond and its related examples. The relationship between coupon, price and yield has already been discussed. Premium and discount in bond pricing and nominal yield, current yield, yield to call and yield to maturity and related examples. All these topics have already been covered in the past three video presentations relating to bond valuation chapter. This is the fourth presentation covering bond valuation. And today we'll be dealing out with some of the most exciting topics of this chapter. We'll start out this video presentation with zero coupon bonds. This topic has already been covered in CA final examination for May 2012. So, zero coupon bonds are issued at a discount and redeemed at par. No interest is paid on such bonds before maturity. Zero coupon bonds may have a face value of say rupees 100. The advantage to the issuer is that it does not entail any cash flow before maturity. That is the best advantage for the issuer of this zero coupon bonds. They don't need to pay any kind of money before maturity. We can see that the value of a zero coupon bond by substituting C, that is coupon, equals to zero in a typical bond situation. So by that, by likely, that means that the value of bond would be the maturity value divided by 1 plus yield with the number of years. It would be simple. And thus, the BO is equivalent to BN divided by 1 plus K to the power N, that is the number of periods. Thus, the value of any zero coupon bond is the face value discounted to its maturity period. The maturity period is given by N in this equation. It is obvious that B0 would always be lower than BN. In other words, BN minus B0 is called as the discount, which is always a positive number. And thus, zero coupon bonds are sold at a discount to their face value. So that was the topic, zero coupon bonds. Now let's discuss about the same related topic as deep discount bonds. When zero coupon bonds are sold at a very large discount, very large discount I mean, to their face value, they take the form of deep discount bonds. Similar to any kind of zero coupon bond, there are no interest payments and investors obtain their return only at maturity. The advantage to the issuer is that it does not entail any cash outflow till the time of redemption or maturity date, same like zero coupon bonds. This instrument is absolutely similar to zero coupon bonds. However, the term of this instrument is usually around 20 to 25 years and it provides an option to investor to early exit, say at the end of 5 years, 10 years and so on. The word deep represents the large discount to the face value prevailing at the time of issue. Consider a zero coupon bond with a face value of rupees 1000 and the term of 20 years with an expected return from the bond at 10%. Then from that equation we can get the bond price as B0 equals to 1000 divided by 1 plus 0.1 whole raised to the power 20. It would come at rupees 149. Guys, this means that the deep discount bond would be selling today for just rupees 149, which is rupees 851 discount to its face value. That is why discount which is being involved is absolutely so deep. That's why it's called deep discount bonds. Now, the valuation has already been discussed, that is B0 equals to BN 1 plus k to the power n. Now let's quickly jump on to another topic, which is perpetuity bond. Perpetuity bond is a bond that pays the same coupon interest rate till perpetuity, that is any time, till it has no maturity period, nothing of such provisions. We have seen that in a dividend discount model, that a stock giving the same dividend in perpetuity has a price of D divided by K. And similarly, in a perpetual bond can be priced and valued as C divided by K. So guys, that was all about zero coupon bonds, deep discount bonds and perpetuity bond. Now let's hop on to another topic, which is callable bonds. Bonds which have a feature that permits the issuer to call back money raised through bonds from investors are called callable bonds. Nowadays, many companies have actually included this provision in their bond issue. They contain a callback feature. It enables the issuer to buy back or redeem the bonds prior to maturity at a stated price, which is called the call price. Corporations like to include this feature with their bonds because it gives them the flexibility for the interest rates drop over towards the life of the bond. The call feature is an option and it doesn't need to be exercised by the firm if in case it wants. In a decreasing rate interest rate scenario, when an issuer calls back the securities which are already been issued in the past, the investors have no choice but to comply. This is called the call risk, a risk that investors have assumed that when they originally purchased the bonds. When a bond is called, the firm ceases to make any additional coupon payment and sends the investor a single terminal payment, that is the call price. However, the firm would always weigh the cost and benefits arising out while making the call. Similar to the call option, a bond may have a put option incorporated that would enable the investor to tender the bond back to the issuer prior to maturity. This scenario may arise if the interest rate rises, that is adverse for investors before and after the bond issue. Most corporate bonds have the provision which allow them to be called if interest rates should drop during the life of the bond or not. Normally, if a bond is called, the bondholder is paid a premium over the face value, known as the call premium. The yield to call is calculated exactly the same as YTM, except that the call premium is added to the face value and the first call date is used instead of the maturity date. Well, that is the only difference between yield to call and yield to maturity. So guys, that was the topic callable bonds. Now let's consider it with an example. Given the 10% 10 year INR 1000 face value bond. Assume bond is called after 5 years of issue on a premium of rupees 40 on that bond. We'll find the yield to call if it sells INR 1000 today. That would be by using the approximate method, rupees 100 coupon rate plus 1040 minus 1000 divided by 5 whole divided by 1000 plus 1040 divided by 2, that is the average price. The YTC would come out to 9.6%. So guys, I guess you got the complete clarity conceptually based regarding the topic of callable bonds as well. In this video presentation, we did cover zero coupon bonds, deep discount bonds, perpetuity bond and callable bonds. Do ensure that you revise these topics completely and holistically so as to ensure that you don't fall short of anybody's expectation during the time of examination. Revise, revise and revise. That is the key to success. I'll be concluding this video with another dose of motivation. Work hard, dream big. Work hard and dream big. Guys, it's just one step more ahead. You need to clear your CA final exams ASAP and then the world is all yours. With this, I'll say thank you on behalf of the ADPedia world. Have a nice day guys Enjoy your day. Take care. Bye.